Chloe. I'm John.
What's going on? What is this? Is this a dream?
No. Well, technically, yes, you are dreaming, but we're projecting all of this on top of your dream.
Huh.
Don't! Sorry, can you not touch that? Thanks.
Now, I represent some people. Well, okay, they're not people. They're more like energy clusters from a dimension of pure harmony, but it's just easier to call them people. We'll do questions after. My people are responsible for giving humanity all its great ideas. We did the wheel. We did penicillin. We gave Thomas Edison the idea for the light bulb. And we gave the guy who drew cartoon light bulbs above people's heads to represent them having ideas. We gave him that idea. Now, the reason I'm talking to you...
So you're not a human?
No. No, and remember what I said about questions?
Then why do you look like a human?
Because your human eyes would melt if you saw our true form. Anyhow...
So you chose to look like this.
Excuse me?
You know, you could appear as anyone, but you chose this guy.
Well, we didn't choose it. No. This form is just how it happens.
Really? Because it's, like, super specific. I mean, you've even got a mustard stain.
I said don't do that!
I'm sorry.
Look, the reason that I'm talking to you is because...
damn it! Listen, 2 years ago we gave you an idea, and you haven't done anything with it!
Let's begin our morning ritual by listing some happy words.
Joy.
I just had the craziest dream. Hey, any plans today? Maybe looking for a job or a place to live or your own belt?
I have a job.
Oh, great. You consider that a job? It's just you get paid in carrots.
Wrong. The carrots are my bonus. I'm paid minimum wage.
Oh, my mistake. What a great job.
That's great. Now do one that's sadder.
So sad. Okay.
It's red hot. Okay, next food. While you're in the zone, come on, let's go.
Oh, okay. So for this one, you're like, oh no, pizza.
Like super sad.
Glenn, could we try a happy one?
Sure.
Chloe?
Yeah, we could do a happy one. The only thing is then I'd have to change the name of the website from sadgirlsholdingfood.com to happygirlsholdingfood.com, and nobody's turned on by that.
Stick to your lane, sweetheart, all right?
We've got businessmen to arouse.
That's it! That's the sad I'm looking for.
Going to bed? Whoa. So this is real?
Yeah. So the idea we want you to pursue is...
Wait. You're an energy cloud, but you rented billboard space.
Yeah.
How's that work?
The same way it does in your world.
You called an advertising company?
Yeah.
With a phone?
Yeah.
You guys have phones?
Okay, they don't look like phones, but it's just easier to say, yes, we have phones. Now—
Who designed the billboard?
You're focusing on the wrong parts of this! We hired a graphic design firm. There was a lot of back and forth because they kept making it too minimalist. It was honestly very frustrating, and I would not recommend them.
Okay. So. What's the idea?
Okay, good. Yes, so...
Is it teleportation?
What? No. The idea we want you to pursue
is a brand new, totally unique, comedic chase sequence for a Tom and Jerry cartoon.
What?
Now, you're already 2 years behind, so...
All the ideas I've had in the last 2 years, that was the one you gave me?
Yeah! Do you remember it?
Yeah, of course. You gave it to me while I was having sex.
Was that not a good time?
Also, Tom and Jerry, do they even still make those?
Possibly. What's wrong?
It's just like, aren't these supposed to be like great ideas? Couldn't I just do teleportation?
What brain do you think is in your head? No, okay, look, you were assigned to Tom and Jerry, so you're doing a Tom and Jerry.
Well, I guess it was pretty unique. There was like a whole twist ending with Tom. I think it was Tom. Is Tom the cat?
I feel good.
What? Vodka.
You're drinking again?
No. After the funeral was over, I thought the regret would eventually go away, but if I'm being honest, I don't want it to. Thank you.
We're here for you, Haley.
Nice share, Haley. Anyone else?
Am I allowed? Because I'm just here with... Oh, yeah, okay. Well, I'm Chloe.
Hi, Chloe.
Cool. So this is my first time. I'm not... I mean, I drink, but, you know, I'm fine. I just wanted to say that hearing my sister talk, I have been so selfish, Haley. But I am here for you. And I'm gonna get my life together. Actually, I am working on a new project that I'm pretty excited about. It's, well, I just started, but, I'm writing a brand new, never before done comedic chase sequence for a Tom and Jerry cartoon. Okay, thanks. We're here for you, Chloe. Isn't that what you're supposed to?
You're doing, what are you doing?
Do they still make those?
Possibly.
They don't.
Well, you know, who knows?
Me. I know.
Sorry, I'm just a little confused. Are you writing an episode or just one chase sequence?
I'm writing a, you know, like a Tom and Jerry.
Why?
What?
Why would you do that?
Because the universe wants me to. Look, my idea is really unique. In mine, Tom, or whoever the tabby cat is, uses a sticky pad thing to catch and kill the mouse, and then he gives a big, sad speech about it.
Okay, first of all, Tom isn't a tabby cat. He's an American shorthair. Second, Jerry has been consistently outmaneuvering Tom for the past 42 years.
Ah.
So you are dreaming if you think that he's gonna be tripped up by some basic glue trap. And third, Tom and Jerry don't talk. We only talked once. It's the second episode of the Bob Ogle season, and most people don't even consider that canon.
Okay. So you're all just... cool with this chick who ran over a Boy Scout troop, but you're gonna nitpick my shit? I mean, isn't this a support group? Support me!
Yeah, I think it's just that it's not a very good idea.
Sit down.
I don't want to do this anymore.
What? What happened?
The idea's bad and, like, no one's gonna like it and... Why are there two of you?
Oh, right, Chloe. This is Jorf.
Jorf?
Please move past it. Jorf will now be co-supervising this idea. Because as of today, this is the most delayed execution of an idea ever.
This new one's not fun. Anyhow, it doesn't matter. I don't want to do it anymore, so just, like, whatever. Give it to someone else, okay?
It doesn't work like that.
That can be arranged.
Wait, now hang on.
We just need you to relinquish the idea ownership.
Yeah, fine, let's do it.
No, Chloe, look, the idea has been rooted in your head for so long that it will have fused onto surrounding memories.
So?
So, removing the idea will also remove those memories forever.
Which memories?
A Memorial Day party, your knowledge of how to ride a bike, and the time your father tearfully apologized for being absent for the first 11 years of your life.
Yep, that's fine.
Chloe, wait, just take some time.
No, I don't want to do this.
I'll get the paperwork. Told you she was a bad bet.
Ah, what is his deal?
He's a
whoa.
Oh, sorry, in our world, isn't as severe.
Oh, that's fun.
Yeah.
He's really rude, but he gets away with it because he's so hot.
Sorry, you think that's hot?
Who's a...
Oh, I said a stunt. Nice stunt, because John just did a stunt.
You did? Yeah, yes.
Oh, you want to see it?
Why would you?
Sure.
Sorry.
Okay. Okay.
Are you gonna?
Yep.
Jesus!
Very nice. Now, if you'll just sign right here.
Did you know we could feel pain in here?
Excellent. The idea will be reassigned the next time you fall asleep. And Chloe, let me just tell you that getting to know you has been absolutely media.
Don't you have work? I'm going to bed. Do you want this on or?
This is the only way that I can talk to you in the real world.
John? Oh, I have so many questions.
Please, we really don't have much time.
Why are you flapping the cap of the honey bear to speak? It looks like you're talking out of his hat. Just move its mouth.
You ask too many
questions. What's going on?
I was just talking to a possessed honey bottle.
Just keep it down.
Listen to me. Don't quit. I get it. It's not a sexy idea. But it's worth finishing because, well, because you haven't finished anything in your whole life. You're a loser.
I don't like this speech.
But I'm a loser too.
Aren't you a cluster of harmonious energy?
Yeah, but I'm the worst one. Every idea I work on gets reassigned. I suck. But we can change that, Chloe. We can break the pattern. Finish something, Chloe. Finish the idea. If nothing else, it'll move you and me in the right direction, and even if that's by just an inch, isn't it worth it?
Ugh, fine.
Yeah! Yes, I knew it!
What is this?
Yes, we're doing
it! Victory dance?
Dance with me, Chloe. Oh, I forgot. You need to finish the idea before it gets reassigned.
When's it being reassigned?
The next time you fall asleep.
Wait, what?
You mean I've got to stay awake until I finish it? I'm tired right now.
Oh, someone's knocking on this bathroom door. I gotta go.
Wait, no, don't go. You've been in a bathroom this whole time?
Shit.
You come over.
I'm willing to go up to, but no further than third base. Also, I need to call you Kyle.
Shut up and listen, okay? I need you to help me write, animate, and screen a Tom and Jerry cartoon before 11 and a half days from now.
Only if you come back to work.
No.
Okay, I'll still do it.
Yes. Okay, hi. I made a thing. Thanks for coming to my thing. Glenn helped me make it. He'd be here, but he's in the hospital for sleep deprivation, but big ups to his brother for coming out. Woo!
Glenn always liked the little thing.
Showtime!
Chasing him. I thought catching him would finally make me happy. But it was the chase that made me happy. And now I miss him. I miss Jerry. I miss him so much.
Okay. So, what do you guys think?
Honestly, this is not what these meetings are for.
Right, but what did you think?
Okay, yeah, I'll say a few words.
Look, you made something, you know? You put yourself out there. How cool is that, right? Trying something just to try? You saw it through to the end, and aside from the whole not sleeping thing, I think this was really healthy.
Thanks, Ailes. But what did you think?
Honestly, I thought it was okay. Chloe. Chloe.
Yeah, sometimes they're just okay.
Biological outbreak. Help. How's the crew dead? We need immediate evac. Someone there?
Not at mission control. I'm inside. No contact so far. Over.
Roger.
Dr. Sara Luis, code 203. I've read the biological facility of the station. We have a containment outbreak. Do you copy?
Captain Kane speaking. We hear you loud and clear. I need a full report of the situation. Go on, Sara. Copy.
Specimen from one of the vessels at X3 is missing. Apparently, to a power malfunction.
What? You need to get out of there. Now. They're gonna shut down the whole operation. Sara, do you read?
Well, I don't care if they do it. I'm going to expose this. My team was in the station. Do you understand? Sara, over. This wouldn't work. Why didn't you listen? I'm so sorry.
Can you hear me? Hey. He's not responsive. Can you look at me? I need to see your eyes. I'll leave you alone.
No. Don't let me bother you. Coming out for some fresh air. Tim, by the way.
Gwen.
What project are you on, Gwen?
I'm in Building 5.
Never met anyone from five, and I've been here 8 years.
Do you mind?
They don't let you out much, do they?
Not really.
Quantum mechanics?
Bio, actually.
You escaped all the way over here.
It's a good view. I needed to get away. We sent a man to Europa today. And brought him back in 2/3 of a second.
What?
I know.
Probably weren't supposed to tell me that, were you?
No.
It's okay. Everyone knows your team had an interplanetary mandate. The work was obviously aiming big, but that's big. It's hard to believe.
I know. I find it hard to believe, and I've been working on it for 15 years. It changes everything.
Implications are massive.
Solar system just got smaller. What am I doing? Shouldn't be talking to you about this.
Hey, don't worry about it. I like my job. I can exercise discretion. I gotta ask, though. Maybe I shouldn't, but why so down? Shouldn't you be celebrating?
I'm gonna tell you this because I have to tell someone. No, it's more than that. It's, I can't remember his name. It was, we've been transporting objects and non-human test subjects for years. What the hell is his name? We were just sitting there where we're hoping that he comes back intact, that we're not sending him to his grave. Harper, Harper, that's his name. Human teleportation. I saw it, it's possible. We test two-way scenarios for obvious reasons. So they send him back to me, and he's there in front of me, and he's alive, and he's breathing, and I check his vitals, his body temperature, his pulse, his neurological system. It's fine. He's coherent, and he's responding to stimuli, and I ask him to say something.
And?
He asked for some water.
Water? So then what?
Well, I brought him some water. But when I gave it to him, I looked into his eyes, and he looked into mine, and nothing.
Nothing? What do you mean, nothing?
I mean, nothing. That human connection, that moment of intimacy, it wasn't there. You see this? This wasn't there. We transported all of the molecules of the cells, the flesh, but we left something behind.
I don't understand.
I just keep seeing those eyes.
Where is he now?
He's still being assessed.
Okay, so we can transport humans thousands of miles in seconds, but they lose something along the way?
all these years I've spent, and I thought I was finally cutting close to some answers. But this.
This is metaphysics. What was that? Oh my God. Did you hear that?
We'll be right back. go.
Touchdown!
Woo!
Yeah, that's good.
For the pain. Please, Dad.
Chimera, and they inject it with human.
Hello, Bardolph.
Miss?
Need to speak with you?
Miss, am I a monster?
No.
I heard your father call me this.
Humans tend to be afraid of anyone a little different to them. That's all.
But I'm not just a little different, am I? Look at my face. My ear, my snout. If these features don't make a monster, what does?
Actions, not appearances. Fear makes humans do terrible things.
Your father has always been terrible. What's he so afraid of?
Me.
But you would do anything for him.
That's exactly right. That's what I need to talk to you about.
What is it?
Father is sick, dying.
I'm sorry.
Biologically, you and my father's organs are a perfect match.
What does that mean?
I need your liver. I understand, Bardolph, you're scared.
Yes. I am scared.
And what are your animal instincts telling you to do?
If this is what you want, I'll do it.
See, Bardolph, you're no monster.
You don't have the ball.